Transgender Protection Rights Bill 2019. Further discussion, please. Sit down. Rajiv, please.
It was legal, but enforced.
No. So you must object to illegal, na? How can you? How can? But no MP can be forced. I am confident. That's why they became MPs. Don't worry. The Transgender Persons Protection of Rights. Please. I know the judgment. Anumantayaji, I know the. You can't give a judgment on the judgment given by the chair. Please. The Transgender Persons Protection Rights Bill. Further discussion. Sri Suresh Prabhu. You are on your legs? No, you are supposed to speak, no? You will be there.
Sir, the other day. Sir, the other day you made a very important remark about the 250th session of this August House. And when you gave a eulogy, which I was saying the other day about the passage of the other bill, which was related to surrogacy, which was just referred to the select committee of the Rajya Sabha. And I was saying that this house and parliament generally is looking at some issues which for a passage of over a passage of time have crossed the stigma of those issues being called as a taboo. There was a time when there was not even when the first session of the Rajya Sabha took place.
Kripya Santi Rakhen. Please. Kripya.
There was not even a definition of transgender was born. The description of a peculiar characteristic that a person has and to describe them as transgender also evolved over a period of time. But even after that, we have seen that transgender community has been discriminated against. They have been suffering various forms of not just treatment from the society, and therefore there has been a demand that there should be a proper regulation and if possible now, a legislation to ensure that this kind of discrimination will disappear over a period of time. So I'm very happy that the Honorable Minister has brought this legislation which covers many important aspects related to the issues of transgender community. First, this is a legislation in which we are talking about discrimination per se. And this is a very important issue. That when we talk about discrimination, all kinds of discrimination have been prohibited, and I am very glad that the list itself is very comprehensive. So I must congratulate the Minister for doing that. All employment, healthcare, education, buying properties, and all kinds of that discrimination will be not allowed under the law, and therefore the welcome thing. I just want to request you to add one more. Verbal abuse. As you know, many times people discrimination also arises from verbal abuses that a person has to receive for being a transgender community person. And that sometimes, as you know, the verbal abuse is more painful, more damaging to a person than just a physical abuse. So physical abuse is one part, but mental abuse is far more important. And therefore, in the wisdom, we also decided to bring in under the Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe Act very stringent provisions about verbal abuse. So if you discriminate a person by abusing him verbally, that also causes far more serious damage to the person's ego, person's ability to perform properly. And therefore, I think that's something which I was saying is not mentioned here. I request you to please include that when we become very comprehensive. Then, on Chapter 3, which deals with recognition of identity of a transgender person, and the welcome provision that a person should go a a transgender person to go to a district magistrate, and district magistrate has to follow a procedure which is not mentioned here. It will be coming in the rules. That is also right, because rules have to come out with such matters. But in that, one thing that we must prescribe in the Act itself is a time limit. By what time limit he will dispose of the application? Let him follow a thorough procedure, but if he does not dispose of this petition for a long time, because there is no time limit prescribed under the Act, probably this will again amount to a denial of a right of the person to be identified with a particular thing. So I think that this should be... Yeah. So that's something we should be very rightly done and try to put into that. Then the welfare measures by the government, which are the part of chapter 4, which are also something which are obligations on the part of the government. I think this is an important thing that we are trying to put it on the part of the government. I would feel that while we talk about government, it is also better to clarify that government means not only central government and state government, but even at the local level. The Jilla Parishads, the village panchayat, there the person lives, he's residing there, and any discrimination and a welfare measure that should be taken must also be taken at that level of the governance also, because that is also an equally important place where a person could be provided welfare measure. And therefore, the government per se should mean also in that aspect. The chapter 5, which also deals with obligations on the part of establishment and other persons. I think this is a rightful place, and to do that, one thing, and you will appreciate it. So the transgender, after having discovered that person, having discovered, and this is your put it, what is transgender has been defined in the section 3, section 2. But what is important is a discrimination, or not even discrimination, but some sort of mental torture starts in the household itself. Because the family itself may not accept the reality that how could my child not be belonging to one of the sexes that we are known of. So therefore, we must have more education at a level of that level so that people will understand and the stigma will disappear for person being called. So I think that particular level, while we talk about establishment of various kind, household itself is one place which is not establishment per se, but should be also included in doing that. I think one of the part chapter 5, chapter 7 deals with National Council for Transgender Persons. If you really look at it yourself, you will see there are so many categories, right from small a to I, are included, in which in the clause G, sub-clause G, you are saying only 5 representatives of transgender community by rotation will be coming. Just imagine, you are making a council for transgender person, and in that, except those 5 persons, obviously all others are non-transgender. So what is the purpose of creating a transgender council in which, barring 5, all other non-transgender? So please, my request is, if you can increase the number, and by saying this will also help the transgender community to actually be participating into this in a proper manner. I think the offences and penalties have been mentioned, and I was saying that there should be some sort of understanding that people who are discriminated against, only offence they are committing is against the person, but also against the community as a whole. So how do you create that awareness about a community as a whole is also very important. So by and large, it's a very important piece of legislation. And I think I must congratulate the government and the minister for bringing a part of this public policy. How do you look at our fellow citizens just because by birth or by other process they have a problem in identifying with a particular sex, but they don't actually have an attitude towards that? How do you deal with such community? So I really congratulate the government and support the bill. I only hope that these few points will be incorporated to ensure that when we are making such a good piece of legislation, we should make it all comprehensive. Thank you very much.
Thank you.